Live from the Mall of Ace Arena, this is the Miss Universe Philippines 2023.
Kabadbaran City, Province of Agusan del Norte.
Avery Tukgam, Municipality of Calibo, Province of Aklan.
Christine May Boca, Province of Apayao.
Jan Marie Bordon, Bacolod City.
Alexandria Bautista Bollier, Bacoor City.
Krishna Marie Gravidez, City of Baguio.
Karen Joyce Mendoza Olfato, Batangas.
Romeleo, Province of Benguet.
Pauline Pucharo Amlings, Bohol.
Princess Anne Panganiban Marcos, Bulacan.
Shane Aglanme Makiran, Province of Capiz.
Samantha Panlilio, Cavite.
Brian Padillo, Cebu City.
Emmanuel Vera, Cebu Province.
Liza Fernando Castro, Davao Oriental.
Irish Ramos, Eastern Samar.
Vanessa Melia Chewi, Province of Guimaras.
Chloe Barl Zulweta Gabales, Iloilo City.
Kimberlyn Acob, Province of Isabela.
Lapu-Lapu City.
Michelle Marquez D. Makati.
Iman Francesca Costal, Mandaluyong City.
Christine Arenas Salcedo, Marin Duque.
Vanessa Yuson Matsai, Negros Oriental.
Leila Yusuf Adriatico, Northern Samoa.
Laika Bungking Inclamado, Occidental Mindoro.
Luis Gallardo, Palawan.
Angelique Manto, Pampanga.
Claire Dacanay, Parañaque City.
Callie Navajo, Pasig City.
Aileen Gonzalez, Quezon City.
Leslie Sim, Quezon Province.
Rain Hillary Carascal, Sorsogon.
Kimberly Scarton, Southern Leyte.
Hira Desiree Coronado Betito from Surigao del Norte.
Nikki Justine Silva Breedveld, Taguig.
Mia Adorable Yeboah, Chaong Quezon.
Christine Julian of Gaza, Province of Zambales.
We'll be right back.
Rapp and Maureen Monte. Let's all welcome Asia's multimedia star, Alden Richards. A multifaceted artist, our Chinito heartthrob, Cien Lim.
Hello, universe! Pageant fans, we can't hear you. Good evening, Mall of Asia Arena. Good evening, Philippines. And of course, let's give a big hand for our Miss Universe Philippines 2023 delegates wearing Chris Nick and shoes by Jojo Bragais.
Good evening, CN. Good evening, universe. Good evening, Mall of Asia Arena. It is our pleasure to be your hosts for tonight as we crown a new set of Miss Universe Philippines queens. And to join us for this special event in Philippine pageantry, let's all welcome on stage and to our country, the longest reigning Miss Universe from South Africa, Miss Universe 2019, Sosibini Tunzi.
Hello, Alden. Good to see you again. I'm so excited to be here. Finally, long time coming. And so let's not waste any time and get this started, Pilipinas. This is
Miss Universe Philippines 2023.
Thank you.
You are still tuned in to the coronation of Miss Universe Philippines 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the last time we will see our 38 delegates together on one stage, because in just a few moments, we will announce the names who will advance to the next round. But before that, let's give away some special awards. And our first special awards is Miss Friendship. She's the friendliest delegate in this batch that captured the hearts of other ladies, and she's the source of love and positivity, even in the middle of the competition. And this year's Miss Friendship is... Agusan del Norte, Janari Sarsoso! Congratulations to our Miss Friendship. And I stand corrected. Miss Friendship is Miss Capiz Shane Glenn May Makiran. But Miss Janari Sarsoso is our face of social media. She is the delegate that effortlessly registers well on screen and photos. Congratulations, girls. Congratulations, ladies. And for the past months, our 38 delegates battled it out in different challenges to bring out the best in them. These challenges include the glam shoot, swimsuit, and runway. And of course, last May 10th, the preliminary competition was held in Ocada, Manila. From 38, only 18 delegates will make it to the next cut. The judges, MUPH organization, and the fan votes determined our top 18. And here are the results. Starting with the three winners in the challenges. Winning the glam shot challenge and taking the first spot in the top 18 is... Agusan del Norte, Janari Sarsoso. And now let's meet the winner of our swimsuit challenge, and she is Bohol Pauline Amelinx. Next, we have the runway challenge winner, and advancing to the next round is Pampanga Angelique Manto. Congratulations to our winners. And now, ladies and gentlemen, 15 spots left. And the next one belongs to Eastern Samar Iris Ramos. You are a step closer to the crown. Makati, Michelle Marquesti. This is your moment. Paranyake, Claire Dacanay. The next spot is for you. Chaong Quezon, Apia Adorable Yeboa. You are part of the top 18. Sorsogon, Rain Hillary Carrascal. Nine spots left, and you still have a chance. Mandaluyong, Iman Francesca Crista. The 10th spot belongs to you, Bacolod, Jean-Marie Bourdon. Come and join the top 18, Cebu Province, Emmanuel Vera. You are also advancing to the next round, Marinduque, Christine Salcedo. You are still part of the competition, Zambales, Christine Opiaza. You still have a chance for the crown, Cavite, Samantha Panililio. You made it this far, Davao Oriental, Claiza Fernando Castro. Three spots remain, and one of them belongs to Baguio, Krishna Marie Gravides. This is your night, Isabella Kimberlyn Ako. And the last delegate advancing to the next round is also the Smiley Casting Fan Vote winner. And she is Bulacan Princess Ann Marcos. This is our top 18. Congratulations to all our delegates. And once again, our Miss Universe Philippines 2023 top 18.
Well done, ladies. Moa Arena, can we please give them a big round of applause? From 38 delegates, we are down to our top 18. And the next level of the competition begins in just a while. But before that, let's acknowledge the hardworking men and women behind the Miss Universe Philippines organization. Attorney Nad Bronce, Head of Legal Affairs. Lia Ramos, Head of Women Empowerment Committee and Charity. Florente Mario Garcia, Business Development and Marketing Head. Albert Andrada, Style Council Head and Fashion Designer. Voltaire Tayac, Director of Communications. Everyone knows him, Jonas Gapud, President and Creative Director. And of course, Shamsi Supsup Lee, National Director and Entrepreneur. And we would also like to acknowledge the presence of Paula Sugart, President of Miss Universe Organization. Congresswoman Richelle Singson Michaels, Miss Universe Philippines Advisor for Women Empowerment. And Miss Olivia Quido, a successful Filipina based in the U.S., who is a top-rated esthetician, entrepreneur, women's advocate, and a Christian philanthropist. Thank you so much, Paula, Congresswoman Richelle, and Miss O for the love and support to the Miss Universe Philippines organization. All right, so with our top 18 revealed a while ago, the biggest question still remains. Ako gusto ko kayo itanongin. Who do you think will bring home the crown? I think you guys have to scream it louder. Man, the difficult decision is in the hands of our esteemed panel of judges. Nasa kanila yung pinakamahirap na trabaho ngayong gabi. And let's get to know them a little bit more. Our first judge, the Managing Director of Smiley Apparel, Lynn Lee. Next up is the Chief Financial Officer and Managing Director of Aqua Boracay, Tony Charmaine Cohan. We also have the Head of Marketing of Avon Philippines and Asia Pacific Region, Anna Garces. Joining our panel of judges is GMA Network Senior Vice President and GMA Films President and CEO, Attorney Annette Gozon Valdez. A licensed civil engineer turned business mogul and philanthropist, the President of Maserati Philippines, and he is also the host of his own show, Dear SB on CNN Philippines, the Director of Charity of Miss Universe Philippines, and a member of the Philippines House of Representatives, Congressman Sam Versosa. Former chairperson of the House Committee on the Welfare of Children, who actively pushed for the passage of important laws that ensure the promotion and protection of the rights of Filipino women and children, such as against trafficking and sexual exploitation. The representative from Tingog Party List and the chairperson of the Board of Judges, Yeda Romualdez. And of course, everyone is excited to see her tonight. We also have as our judge the reigning Miss Universe 2022, Arbony Gabriel. And of course, one Miss Universe to the next. Our next judge is Miss Universe 1973, Margarita Margie Moran Florendo. We also have the Executive Director of NetAsia Industries Incorporated, Lloyd Lee. Dentist to the Stars for Advanced Dentistry, Dr. Nelda Eufemio. Everyone knows her, former Women's National Tennis Champion, Sports TV host, and Miss Universe correspondent of ABS-CBN Broadcasting, Miss Diane Castillejo. Chief Marketing Officer of Jewelmer, Marion Brandelic de Guzman. Once again, all the best to the panel of judges. Please do enjoy the show dahil nasa inyo talaga ang pinakamahirap na trabaho for tonight. So MOBO Arena, Universe, you have met our top 18 and of course our panel of judges and our board of Miss Universe Philippines directors. I think it's time to meet again our backstage correspondents who's hanging out at the Smiley Apparel Lounge. Tim and Maureen, take it away.
Thank you, Sian. What a powerful top 18 we have this year. Everyone is deserving of the crown. But before anything else, welcome to the Smiley Apparel Lounge. This beautiful setup was done by the very talented event stylist, Gary Dakanay.
Gary Dakanay is also the creative man behind our prelim setup, red carpet flower arrangements, and the judges' table setup from the prelims up to the coronation. Thank you, Gary Dakanay, for sharing your talent to the universe.
You know, Maureen, I have my personal bets, but really, choosing the winners is really up to the judges.
That's right, Tim. Earlier, we met the 12 members of our panel of judges. But if you have the Miss Universe Philippines app, you can be the 13th judge.
What?
Yes.
How is that possible?
You heard it right, Tim. To all of our viewers, all you have to do is download the Miss Universe Philippines app and vote for your favorite delegate and help them advance to the next round.
Wow, so we have the power to vote for our favorite delegates. That is awesome. And now that we have our top 18, when we vote on the app, we can help the delegate of our choice to advance to the top 10. So to all of you guys watching right now, download the Miss Universe Philippines app and vote, vote, vote.
Vote now because there will be no tomorrow for our delegates. Download the app now and vote.
Maureen, I'd like to ask you, how can you say that a Filipina is talagang Pilipina?
Oh, I have to say, ang talagang Filipina ay talagang matapang, confident at mahusay. Kaya naman, welcome to the new era. Narito na ang talagang Pilipina. Ipakita ang pagiging talagang Pilipina with Avon, the number one makeup brand in the country. This is
Miss Universe Philippines 2023.
Iba't ibang itsura. Pero sino ba ang Pilipinang Pilipina? Wala sa itsura. Pero nasa kulay ng bawat gawa. Maaring pula para maipakita ang marka ng pagmamahal. O ginto para maipakita ang mukha ng tagumpay. Kung minsan ay luntian para tingnan ang pangangalaga sa kalikasan. Pwedeng rosas para ipadama ang pag-ibig na wagas. Isang kayumanggi na nagpapamalas ng lakas anumang hamon ng kaharap. At itim para maipakita ang tunay na determinasyon upang mapabuti ang buhay ng iba at ng mundo.
Sino ang Pilipinang Pilipina? Makulay. From Avon, the country's number one makeup brand.
We'll be right back. Di ba hamba ko sa'yo mo maging A-Stop ka? Magpakatatag ka.
Those who are strong in heart always end up on top.
Strong and durable. With SOEN, inner self matters.
The most beautiful night in the Philippines continues. This is Miss Universe Philippines 2023, the coronation. Mall of Asia, how are you feeling? I feel the same. All our delegates are phenomenal and transformational, but above all, they are Filipinas. Being in a competition like Miss Universe Philippines is something that would entail a lot of personal sacrifices. For months, they went through different challenges, but I must say, I'm impressed so much with their performances and their resiliency. Truly, each of our delegates has a story to tell, and they are already a part of this year's Her Story. Let's get to know them even more.
Despite the doubts, despite the wounds, despite the setbacks, I overcame. I believe that preservation starts with awareness.
Just when I thought my journey had ended, the universe made an unexpected turn to keep my dream alive.
I take my hardships, struggles, and sorrows and turn them into inspiration.
It gives me great pride to be walking the paths my family walked.
Surrounded by the serene greenery, carrying thousands of hardening dreams, I continue my Miss Universe Philippines journey with courage and a clear purpose, to represent my hometown of warriors.
To the woman I am today, I owe it to all the silent and deafening battles that I have fought bravely to look after myself and my family.
I owe it to myself to be fearless and free, but more to my community, to be resilient and caring.
Our strong spirit keeps on looking for hope in the dark, to find more meaning in the life we live, and to keep going even against the odds.
Malambing man magsalita, hindi nagbabagapi ang mga bulakenya.
As the fire ignites brighter and brighter within me, I will carry my purpose with gratitude and humility.
What makes these women empowered and confident is their resilience, their determination, and their unwavering belief in themselves.
Our delegates prove themselves to be worthy to be part of this year's batch. Well done, ladies. Ito na, ang tanong ko sa inyo, guys. MOA Arena, are you ready for the hottest part of the competition? It's time for our top 18 to show the universe the true beauty and strength of a Filipina. Together with SV Squad and DJ Patty Chu, they are ready to walk and win with Bragais. Here's the swimsuit competition of Miss Universe Philippines 2023, brought to you by Aqua Boracay. Thank you.
A BS Accounting Technology magna cum laude, who managed to put up her own cafe in the middle of the pandemic. Business is her forte, Agusan del Norte. This Boholana Belgian is a certified AIDA 2 freediver and has created a marine-themed children's educational coloring book to spark action and awareness for the younger generation. Be proud and stand tall, Bohol! Pampanga, Angelique Manto. This young achiever has been at the top of her class from grade school to college. A former USD courtside reporter who now works as a sports show host and content creator. Such an inspiring saga. Pampanga. Samar, Irish Ramos. Irish took up nursing from UB Manila and entrepreneurship from Enderun College. She's also a creative person who loves to write essays and poems. You set the bar, Eastern Samar. Michelle Marquez D. This award-winning actress and model is a psychology graduate who also finished Entrepreneurship Essentials at Harvard University Online. She's a certified adrenaline junkie. You've got the face and the body. Makati! Paranyake, Claire Dakanay. This single mom who loves cooking and boxing used to be a professional softball player and is now pursuing interior design. Passionate, persistent, phenomenal. Paranyake. Chaong Quezon, Afia Adorable Yeboa. This geodetic engineer cum laude loves solving puzzles and watching documentaries. To complement her Morena beauty, she explores different makeup styles suited for her skin. We adore your complexion, Chaong Quezon. Sorsogon, Rain Hillary Carrascal. This talented lady loves to sing and dance. She's also an aspiring lawyer who worked hard to support and put herself through college, graduating with a degree in business administration. Such an inspiring Oragon, Sorsogon! Mandaluyong, Iman Francesca Cristal. Meet this content creator and live streamer who is also a financial advisor and loves singing, performing, playing drums, and painting. Own the stage because it's where you belong. Mandaluyong! By Aqua Boracay with Bacolod, Jean-Marie Bordon. This musically inclined tourism management student is an acoustic band vocalist, a songwriter, and has worked as a dance instructor since the age of 15. You got the looks, the talent, and the bod. Bacolod! Cebu Province, Emmanuel Vera. An actress, model, singer, and songwriter. She's a jack of all trades who also loves rock climbing, surfing, and water sports activities. Rock us with confidence, Cebu Province. Salcedo. She finished her entrepreneurship degree with Latin honors at the University of Santo Tomas and is currently working for their family business handling sales, marketing, and operations. Marching in is our cum laude, Marinduque. Zambales. Christine Opiaza. Notice the walk of this pasarela coach who's also a freelance model and a host. She's also into writing short essays and motivational quotes. Your walk is a yes. Zambales. Cavite. Samantha Pandillo. This alumna from the University of California, Irvine is now working as a COO of an established company, but still admits she's a farmer at heart. Such a humble beauty. Cavite. Oriental, Liza Castro. From the indigenous tribe of Mandaya, this communication graduate is a commercial and runway model and live streaming host who loves public speaking and debating. An outspoken lady with high morale, Davao Oriental. Fabio Krishna Marie Gravides. There can never be anyone more business-minded than this civil engineering student who started selling lip tints, flavor drinks, and ukay-ukay items at a very young age to fund her own education since senior high. We're all in awe. Bagyo! Isabella Kimberlyn Ako. This teacher from Kabatuan is a dual degree holder in tourism management and secondary education major in social science. Teaches how to do the pasarela, Isabella. Bulacan, Princess Anne Marcos. Her YouTube followers know her as the Millennial Bukid Girl. Aside from being a content creator, this industrial engineering cum laude at UP Diliman is also a CEO of a tech company. Oh yes, you can, Bulacan.
Once again, together with the SV Squad, your Miss Universe Philippines 2023 Top 18 Swimsuit Competition brought to you by Aqua Boracay. And now, let's reveal the name of the delegate who truly stood out from the rest of the Top 18 in their swimwear. The Miss Universe Philippines 2023 Best in Swimsuit is... Miss Bagyo Krishna Marie Gravides. Congratulations to you, Ms. Bagyo, our best in swimwear. And now let's check out the latest happening at the Smiley Apparel Lounge. What's up, Tim and Maureen?
Thank you, Alden. That was a fiery and hot as summer swimsuit competition we had right there. Congratulations to our top 18. I think that I could even wear one of those swimsuits during my next summer escapade.
That's right, Maureen. You'll make the temperature go rising. And you know what? I want to book a flight to Boracay right away. And I can stay in Aqua Boracay, of course. That is for sure.
At this point, we would like to thank our partners and sponsors. Smiley Apparel, co-presenter and official basic apparel partner. Cream Silk, official hair care partner. Pons, official face care partner.
Kimmons, official body care partner. Avon, official makeup partner. Ori G, official beverage. And of course, we would like to thank our other sponsors too.
Yes. SoN Lingerie, our official intimate apparel partner. Jewelmer, our official accessory partner. Hello Glow, official sun care partner.
PLDT Home, official broadband partner. Jojo Braga is our official footwear sponsor. And also, yes, Philippine Airlines, our official airline partner.
Right now, we still have a complete top 18, but in a few moments, since we just had our swimsuit competition, 8 of them will be eliminated from the competition.
But hey, don't lose hope for your favorite delegate. All you have to do is download the Miss Universe app and vote for your favorite delegate and help them advance to the top 10.
We have the power to vote for our favorite delegates from the top 18. Vote on the Miss Universe Philippines app now and help the delegate of your choice advance to the top 10.
So don't forget to vote now because the announcement of the top 10 is coming right up. So right up, right app, exactly. Download the app right now and vote.
Tim, since we are here at the Smiley Apparel Lounge, I think we can flex that Smiley is a 100% Filipino-made shirt brand that we can all be proud of.
Yes, you are worth a Smiley Apparel, the shirt that sets the standard. This is Miss Universe Philippines 2023.
Sa ating mga Pilipino, hindi pwede ang pwede na. Lahat tayo, matitipag. Matitino. Magagaling. At higit sa lahat, tunay na malikhain.
Hindi ba dapat sa talamig pa lamang natin ay nakikapakita natin sino tayong talaga?
Itinatag ang Smiley Apparel dahil sa paniniwala sa kakayahan ng Pilipino.
Paniniwala nito, kayang-kaya nating gumawa ng mga damit na may pagmamalaki natin sa buong mundo.
Gawa ng Smiley Apparel ay mga damit na tunay na naglalarawan sa kahanga-hanga nating mga kakayahan. Bawat produkto ng Smiley Apparel ay masusing ginagawa ng magagaling na mananahing Pinoy. Para ang Pinoy na tunay na world class. At higit sa lahat, ginagawa ang lahat ng Smiley Apparel dito sa ating bansa. Para man ito sa pang-araw-araw,
pang-opisina, para sa sports at iba pa. Ang damit mo ay de kalidad
at abot kaya. Yan at wala nang iba ang nararapat para sa iyo.
The Filipino fashion is worth it. You are worth a Smiley Apparel.
Smiley Apparel, the shirt that sets the standard.
Mahalaga anak ay komportable ka kung sino ka.
Mabuti ang nasa loob mo.
Lagi mo yan tatandaan, ha?
brings confidence. With Soen, inner self matters.
To win, I should put on more work, do more than what is expected. That is the way of a winner. That is my way. My bits should look like a winner too. So I need a product that doesn't give me the usual. One that does more and achieves more. This is my winning way for a great skin. This is the key man's way. Put on more work. Do more than what is expected. That is the way of a winner. That is my way. My skin should look like a winner too. So I need a product that doesn't give me the usual. One that does more and achieves more. This is my way for a great skin. This is the Keyman's way.
The coronation of Miss Universe Philippines 2023 continues right here at the Mall of Asia Arena. Hello, Philippines! Are you all excited to find out who makes it to the top 10? I know I am. I can't wait to find out as well. But before that, let's get to know more about some of our delegates. All of them have different stories to tell, and they also have different advocacies that are worthy to be pushed forward. Let's listen to them and admire the her story they've made for themselves.
Life will go on, and I need to fight and become a better version of myself, because life with purpose is worth living. From the culture of unconditional kindness I've learned from my farming community, we will never run out of love and good energy to give to others as well as to ourselves. That is the legacy that I want to leave.
As an SK chairman for 5 years now, I have seen the impact of simple acts of kindness, how they ripple and multiply. I am determined in being able to provide my peers and the youth in general with the appropriate tools to help them with their short and long-term goals.
As I advocate for optimal mental health, nestled within me are 1,000 stories to tell. The journey wherein healing upon me befell is a story that stars Cebu and myself.
Basta Mandaya, Mati Mawa.
Eastern Samar is known as the gateway to Philippine discovery, and to the Siang Estehanon, it is the land of self-discovery.
My work with the Department of Agriculture Philippine Rural Development Project allowed me to stay grounded and focus my advocacy on the environment and social safeguard.
My mission is to give every aspiring Ilonggo the chance to transform. Just how Iloilo transformed me to be phenomenal. Pinasahi nga Ilongga.
Nagalak akong siya ay hindi nakalimot sa pinanggalingan. Ang nangangarap noon ay isa ng inspirasyon ngayon.
Everyone deserves to feel safe, welcome, accepted, and supported no matter who they are or whom they love.
If there's one thing that I learned from life, it's that there is no reason for you not to achieve the things that you want to achieve. Don't give yourself a meal. Take two. If there's one thing that I learned from life, is that there is no excuse for you not to achieve the things that you want to achieve. Don't give yourself a million reasons not to do it. Just make it happen.
A person who was once at her rock bottom built herself up and be where she currently is now. A person who has risen above their past, not leaving it behind, but now taking it with me to share lessons I've learned all throughout. This is me telling you that if I was able to do it, then so can you.
Marvel in its beauty. Marinduque.
To admit that Maureen and I are having a lot of fun, and we're also getting a heart attack here at the Smiley Apparel Lounge. I think I can't handle the pressure of being the one to announce the names of the delegates who made it to the next round.
I have to agree, Tim. Job well done to all of our delegates who made it into the top 10. You are a step closer to the crown, so prepare and focus on the next round of the competition. To all of our viewers right now, did your favorite delegates make it to the next cut? If yes, it's because you helped them move forward by voting for them on the Miss Universe Philippines app.
And we are here to remind everyone that voting is on again. Help your delegate make it to the final five. Vote right now because you can help them secure a spot.
Vote as if your life depends on it. Oh, wait. Vote because your favorite delegate depends on you.
Yes, stay with us here a little longer. Maureen, right now, what can we look forward to the next part of the competition?
The evening gown competition is up next, so we can all look forward to our lovely delegates wearing the creations of Filipino designers. This is the part where we take pride of the creativity and artistry of our very own artists.
At the same time, I cannot wait for the Q&A segment. It's time for them to speak and have a mic drop moment. We are living for pageant moments like this.
You are absolutely right, Tim. It's getting more and more exciting. This is
Miss Universe Philippines 2023.
Miss Universe Philippines and Cream Silk present The Carovers.
A world of ultimately beautiful women.
What does it mean to be ultimate?
To be ultimate means being straight with your goals.
Respect all people.
Celebrate every human being.
Believe in the youth.
To be ultimate means to shine in this world.
Be a role model.
Overcome discrimination.
Keep the dream alive.
To be ultimate means, if you fall,
come back stronger.
Welcome new challenges.
Train hard. Never stop fighting.
To be ultimate means to show your real colors.
Be an ally to those who struggle.
Wear your battle scars proud.
Speak what's on your mind.
Seek your ultimate.
And encourage other Filipinas to do the same.
From the ultimate keratin conditioner, to give ultimately beautiful hair, Cream Silk.
You are still tuned in to the coronation of Miss Universe Philippines 2023 live at the Mall of Asia Arena. Tonight, we honor not just the unique beauties of the Filipinas, but we also want to highlight them as phenomenal and transformational leaders through and through. The ultimate beauty of our delegates cannot be restricted to just one definition. It comes in many, many variations. And all these queens have proven to us in the past weeks that they have what it takes to become their most beautiful selves to reach their ultimate. Let's get to know more of them as they empower others through their causes and they showcase their authenticity as a queen. This is how they make her story happen.
A Filipina doesn't let setbacks or obstacles hold their back. Instead, they use them as opportunities to grow and learn.
It's about the small things in Negros Oriental. It's about existing from day to day and not worrying about tomorrow.
This journey might not be easy, but with God's guidance and the support of those who believe in me, I am unstoppable. Northern Samar, this is just the beginning.
The entire event that has happened is part of our history. Those that contribute to who we are now and will guide the next generation of Mindoreños in facing tomorrow. While some turn the stones thrown to them into tower, I turn mine into gold. It has strengthened me, toughened me, and made me into the woman I am today.
From that day to this day, every moment in between made me. But now, I am a survivor, taking steps to reclaim my strength and remind myself that I am enough and that every single step I take is a step towards healing.
I am not a perfect mom. I have my lapses. I have my imperfections. I am flawed. He has a mom who will go 101% for him, no matter what others will say.
Hope and happiness, two words that I found as destiny led my feet towards a special place with special people. More than being a Daragang Magayon, the humble life I was born into in Sorsogon molded me to become a true Daragang Oragon. Because of my struggles, it made me the empowered woman I am today and what I'm here for.
No matter who I've become or where I've been, the waves of wonders always wash me back to your shores. This is where it all began.
Choice is a theme in my life. I chose to live. I chose to be happy despite the pain. I chose my new home, and now I'm choosing to inspire.
This place never made me feel different.
Naging mapanghamon ang karamihan ng araw, ngunit naging matatag ang bawat isa sa pamilya.
To everyone watching here tonight, and to everyone watching at home via online streaming, we have an announcement to make. This is gonna make tonight a little interesting. Due to technical issues, we've resulted into manual tallying, which means our top 18 candidates will go through the evening gown and compete for the top five. I think it's time to scream out your bets. Who do you think it is? Oh man, they're really excited here. Welcome to a universe of ultimately beautiful hair made possible by Crims Cream Silk Triple Keratin Rescue. Ladies and gentlemen, here are your Miss Universe Philippines 2023 top 18. in their evening gowns.
Competition begins with Agusan del Norte. As a psoriasis warrior herself, she hopes to empower more people and help achieve their ultimate through her story of turning pain into power by taking an active role in lobbying for the passage of the psoriasis bill that can benefit millions of Filipinos living with psoriatic disease. A proud advocate of marine conservation through art and kids. And as the president of an all-women leadership development organization, she is optimistic to build communities that protect and care for the ocean that sustains us all. That's how she can achieve her ultimate. By sharing her own stories of struggles and triumphs, which resonate with others on their own mental health journey, she aims to create more safe spaces for deepening conversations about mental health in the Philippines. To be ultimate is to be able to speak up and seek the support we need to live our best lives. Established an egg farm as a response and aid to the shortage of protein sources in her hometown. She also headed outreach programs for the elders and families in Arteche. All these initiatives are aimed at ultimately helping her community. As a firm believer that through perseverance and dedication, no dream is ever impossible to achieve, she wants to encourage women to become transformational leaders by example. She wishes to inspire everyone to be their ultimate self, to be empathetic, and to never leave anyone behind. Despite juggling different responsibilities, her journey of motherhood has propelled her to surpass her capabilities and become the ultimate version of herself, not only as a mother, but as a woman. Growing up in the Philippines, where Black representation is lacking, she wants to continuously prove to herself and others that one's physical appearance is never a hindrance in reaching one's ultimate. Happy and progressive communities, not just for her province, but for the entire country through the Happy Life Project, which aims to reach remote areas around the country, lending a helping hand to those in need. That is her ultimate dream. Her own share of challenges in life. She's a self-harm survivor and a mental health advocate, using her own experiences to inspire and encourage others. Her message is simple yet powerful. If she can achieve her ultimate, then so can you. Desire to promote mental health awareness among the youth and inspire them with her own story of overcoming adversities. Through Miss Universe Philippines, she knows she can be her ultimate and make a positive impact. As a mental illness survivor herself, she takes from her own experiences and studies to help others overcome mental strongholds, optimize their mental well-being, and consequently live their best possible lives. With these efforts in place, she is able to achieve her ultimate. wants to inspire Filipino children to have a positive attitude towards education and use it as a tool to turn their dreams into reality. By instilling a love for learning in young minds, she hopes to create a generation of passionate and successful learners who will reach their ultimate, just as she does. Platform. She hopes to raise awareness about mental health issues, particularly for her fellow breadwinners who may be struggling with this. In order for us to reach our ultimate, we must give importance to every aspect of our well-being. Empower local farmers in sustainable agriculture is her goal. She wants to break that stigma and educate people that sustainable farming is not only good for the environment, but can also be a very prosperous business if done correctly. Our local farmers' hard work and dedication reflect the true heart of a Filipino, and she wants that to be ultimately known. As a Filipina with indigenous roots from the Mandaya tribe of Davao Oriental, she feels a deep connection with this community and wishes to broaden this advocacy to help the livelihoods of different tribes across the Philippines. No one gets left behind and everyone achieves their ultimate. She is the founder of Color the World with Kindness, a campaign that encourages children to explore their creativity and preserve the arts that are important to Baguio's culture. Through this, she knows she's not only reaching her ultimate, but also helping the young generation to reach their ultimate potential too. A genuine passion for inspiring and shaping young minds. Investing in the youth is key to building a brighter future, characterized by peace and productivity. This is instrumental in achieving the ultimate for our country, raising impactful leaders and builders of tomorrow. Been a strong advocate of agriculture and fisheries through her page, Millennial Bukid Girl, since 2019, and founded Iyong Tanglao Foundation in the same year to extend a helping hand to the Bulaqueños. Through these efforts, she is hopeful to reach her ultimate.
our Miss Universe Philippines 2023 top 18 in their evening gowns. Ladies, y'all look stunning. You look beautiful. And truly, you have achieved your ultimate. But only one of you is deserving for our next award. And that award is the Best in Evening Gown. The results are in. Thank you, sir. You are this year's Best in Evening Gown. Makati Michelle Marquez D. And there you have it, MOA Arena, Filipinas Universe. Give it up once again for the top 18 of Miss Universe Philippines 2023. All right, let's check out the latest happening at the Smile Apparel Lounge with Tim and Maureen. What's up, Tim?
Thank you, Sian. Our lovely delegates really looked regal in their evening gowns. Props to the Filipino designers for continuously giving us something to marvel at every evening gown competition.
Totally, Maureen. You know, proud Pinoy moments as always for our designers. Bravo to all of you guys. And I also have to commend our top 18 in their evening gowns. Great job, ladies.
Thank you also to our partners and sponsors who made this night possible. And if you want your favorite delegate to move past the top 18, you have to vote for them on the Miss Universe Philippines app and increase their chances of advancing to the final five.
We cannot stop reiterating for all of you guys to keep on voting because this is the last stretch of the competition. Vote like there's no tomorrow because you have a few minutes left for your favorite delegates.
Head over to the Miss Universe Philippines app and vote because every vote counts. Again, this is your very last chance to help the cause of your favorite delegate in the top 18 for them to advance to the final five.
Final five coming right up is a special performance from a Pinoy pride and an empowered woman we love so dearly. We will have American Idol Season 11 runner-up on the MUPH stage. Jessica Sanchez is next. This is the coronation of Miss Universe Philippines 2023.
Phone buzz, you know what it is. Group chat says we go all out. Red rope and we stepping through. Top shelf and it's on the house. Can't kill this vibe, baby. We go all night, baby. Sun's up, but this ain't the end. About to do it all again.
Here we go. I shine, we shine, you already know. Here we go. I shine, we shine, you already know. Top sunsets, late night breakfast, young and reckless, never gets old. Top that guest list.
Kaming lahat from the Miss Universe Philippines organization, including the girls, napawaw talaga kami.
Here we go!
Because this has been the grandest welcome we've ever received.
Here we go!
maaari pa na manatili pa nang masilayan kagandahan na isang hiwaga nagkakulay na
parang isang bulalakaw minsan dadaan sa kalawakan
sa paghabi-habi ng oras nagtagpong kapalaran sa paghabi-habi ng oras mundo ay kinulayan
habi-habi ni kaya di makapaniwala
sa paghabi-habi ng oras tayo'y habi ng
Bahan ba sa sa'yo mo maging Eastern ka? Magpakatatag ka?
Those who are strong in heart always end up on top.
Strong and durable. With So-En, inner self matters.
Win,
women empowerment has always been the heart of the Miss Universe Philippines organization. They are at the forefront of strengthening women's sense of self-worth, the ability to make their own choices, and to allow them to take charge to influence social change for themselves and others. Thank you, Miss Universe Philippines organization, for recognizing that empowering women is the fundamental right of women. Ladies and gentlemen, here's the American Idol season 11 runner-up and an empowered Filipina herself, Jessica Sanchez.
Just on it.
Thank you so much, Miss Universe Philippines, for having me. I want to hear you shout in this arena. Come on, Philippines. Y'all ready to hear me sing one more song? Here we go. Come on.
Entrepreneur and National Director of Miss Universe Philippines.
Hello, Universe! As the National Director of the Miss Universe Philippines, I am filled with immense pride and gratitude. This platform holds the power to inspire, uplift, and empower not only women, but every Filipino, regardless of gender or background. In a world that often tries to dim our shine, the Miss Universe Philippines stands as a beacon of hope, reminding us of the infinite possibilities that lie within us. Tonight, we are not only celebrating beauty, intelligence, and talent. We are celebrating the power of our dreams, the strength of character, and the unwavering spirit that resides in the hearts of every Filipino. Tonight is also a reminder that our influence extends far beyond this stage. It is in our everyday actions, our words, and our choices. Each one of us has the power to uplift and inspire and to make a positive impact in our communities and in the lives of those around us. So together, let us celebrate our shared journey, our collective dreams, and the remarkable power that lies within us. For it is when we come together, united in purpose and passion, that we truly shine the brightest. Thank you again to everyone for being part of this incredible journey. May we all continue to inspire, empower, and uplift one another, creating a legacy that will forever illuminate the path for future generations. Remember, the universe is within us. Let us shine together. Maraming salamat po.
Representative Yeda Romualdez of Tingog Party List.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight is not just a celebration of beauty, it is also a special event when we get to listen to 38 young women who are self-aware and have strong opinions about the issues today. To all the delegates, I want to congratulate all of you because you have come a long way. The journey that you had for the past months as you compete for the Miss Universe title is no ordinary feat. Whatever tonight's outcome will be for each of you, allow me to share some things I hope would stay with you as you continue to pursue your goals. First, know your value and stay true to your values. These will serve as your anchor as you navigate through life. This competition has given you the opportunity to know yourself deeper and to find lifelong friendships in your fellow delegates. These are things that no one can take away from you. Hold on to that, because life is more than medals, more than titles and accolades. It is about the relationships we have and the value that we put into our lives, especially for others every single day. Second, never stop investing in yourself. You are your greatest asset. Continue to learn and improve yourself. Nourish your identity and take pride in your uniqueness. Whatever path or role each of you might choose after tonight, stand out and be the best in it. And finally, find your voice and speak your truth. As Miss Universe Philippines delegates, you already have the influence and the platform. Start with that. Use it to rally people to your causes and speak for all those who cannot speak for themselves. Take action so that the vulnerable are heard and protected. As you continue to carve your own story and make life choices, I pray and hope you will always use your values as your light, use your voice as your strength, and may you always remember that there is immense power in your truth. To the next Miss Universe Philippines, I know that you will represent our country with pride and carry our flag with dignity. I pray that you will bring home the crown and show the universe once again how phenomenal all Filipinas are. Maupay nga gabi ha inyong tanan.
Mabuhay, Philippines! Mabuhay, Manila! Hello! I absolutely love being here. And you know, a few years ago, I never realized that I would hold the self-confidence and the self-belief that I do now. I was filled with self-doubt, but luckily, along my pageant journey, I met some women that really believed in me. And they saw things in me that I didn't see in myself, and they reframed my perception on myself. They invested in me, and they really pulled out my strengths and my capabilities that I didn't realize I had. And I cannot thank these women enough. And to me, the definition and the true essence of a woman is one that can identify not only her personal strengths, but she can also bring out the strengths in other women. And so, as I stand here today, I encourage you to do the same, because this platform and the Miss Universe organization is truly about bringing out our strengths in our communities. And anyone here, any woman that graces this stage, anyone in the audience, and anyone on the screen, I want to remind you that you hold the powers and the abilities to do whatever you desire in life, and you must discover it. And I thank the woman that helped me discover it. So with that being said, as women, may we continue to rise against all the trials and challenges that we have. May we continue to pull out the strengths in each other. And must we never shy away from using our voice to transform this world. Thank you.
our Miss Universe Philippines 2023 delegates, Miss Jessica Sanchez, Shamse Supsup Lee, Representative Yeda Romualdez, and Miss Universe 2022, Arbonim Gabriel. As we celebrate women empowerment at this very moment, we would like to acknowledge a woman who has led this cause in her own ways. A true Filipina beauty queen who has represented Philippines in the Miss Universe stage. In fact, this is our second Filipina Miss Universe. And she is celebrating her 50th anniversary since she's been crowned. Ladies and gentlemen, with pride, honor, and joy, let's give it up. A big hand for our Miss Universe 1973, Miss Margie Moran Florendo. Nais po naming magpasalamat. Thank you for continuously inspiring women from all generations. You are a true queen para sa aming lahat. Miss Universe Philippines 2023 will be right back.
To win, I should put on more work, do more than what is expected. That is the way of a winner. That is my way. My bits should look like a winner too. So I need a product that doesn't give me the usual. One that does more and achieves more. This is my winning way for a great skin. This is the Key Man's Way. I should put on more work, do more than what is expected. That is the way of a winner. That is my way. My skin should look like a winner too. So I need a product that doesn't give me the usual. One that does more and achieves more. This is my way for a great skin. This is the Key Man's Way.
You are still tuned in to the coronation of Miss Universe Philippines 2023 live at the Mall of Asia Arena. Tonight, we started with 38 stunning delegates. Then, we met our top 18. And now we're about to narrow down the list again. This time, we are announcing the final five of this year's Miss Universe Philippines. Tabulated and verified by our official accounting firm, SGV & Company, represented by Mr. Alan Ocho. Thank you, Sir Alan. The results are in. Here are this year's top five in no particular order. You earn the first spot in the final five. Baguio Krishna Marie Gravines. Please take center stage because you are advancing to the final round. Pampanga, Angelique Manto. Three spots left. And one of them belongs to you. To win the crown. Zambales, Christine Opiesa. And now, one spot left. Completing our final five is Makati Michelle Marquez team. Universe, take a look at our final five, and one of them is going to be the Miss Universe Philippines 2023. There's no time to rest, ladies. Our question and answer portion happens right now. For our final five, you have to pick a name of a judge who will then ask you a question. And you have 30 seconds to answer. And after 30 seconds, you will hear this sound. All right, let's start with you, Miss Baguio. Thank you. The judge who will be asking your question is Ms. Diane Castillejo.
Good evening, Ms. Baguio. Thank you. You are super gorgeous. So my question is, trans women athletes are now being allowed to compete in women's sports events in many international competitions. Do you think that this is a step in the right direction? Why or why not?
I am all for equality with all genders, and I believe that we have the right to participate in any sports. However, I believe that there's a biological reason that we should not allow trans woman in the woman category because I believe that there's a right time for that and there's right measurements to be done. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Baguio.
Thank you so much, Ms. Baguio. Next, we have Ms. Pampanga. Your judge, Ms. Pampanga, is Attorney Annette Gozon Valdez.
Hello. This is my question. There were calls by some sectors to ban movies and TV shows that portray the Philippines in a bad light. Should we? Why or why not?
I believe that in every aspect, there are two things. There are the good and the bad. But it's in the matter of how we receive the images that we are sharing about the Philippines. We always share the good, the beauty there is in the Philippines, but we must also accept that in every aspect there is the bad, and we must learn and grow from that and improve the country that we are in. And hopefully we see Philippines for the good and the bad and celebrate it and allow us to appreciate the country we are in.
Thank you, Ms. Pampanga. Next, we have Ms. Bohol. Your question, Ms. Bohol, will be coming from our representative, Yeda Marie Romualdez.
Maadjung gabi. There are reports of online sexual exploitation of women and children. As a woman, how do we make the digital space safe for you and other women and children?
I make the digital space safe by taking the lead in that action, by making sure that what I put out there is the truth and is also a message of hope for everyone else. And for anyone that finds himself or herself in such a situation, know that there are people out there who will be able to help you, reach out to you, and make sure that you will be able to get through this, and we can make a difference together.
Thank you, Ms. Bohol. Next, we have Ms. Zambales. Your question, Ms. Zambales, will be coming from Mr. Lloyd Lee.
Hi.
Hi, good evening.
Good evening, Ms. Zambales. Here's my question. A recent Goldman Sachs study found that artificial intelligence tools, or AI, could impact 300 million full-time jobs worldwide, which could lead to a significant disruption in the job market. What do you think of this?
We are moving forward progress and growth, but change is not always about progress. We have to consider that manpower really pulls off the economic development of each and every country. We have to put importance in each and every person, making their crops be seen in each and every aspect in the country. So we have to balance the AI and also the importance of having manpower in the country. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Zambales. And now, Ms. Makati. Your question will be coming from Congressman Sam S.V. Versosa.
Ms. Makati.
Good evening.
Here's our question. Income inequality is still high in the Philippines. The gap between the rich and the poor remains. How do we close that gap?
I think first we have to recognize what we have and the privileges that we have, such as food, education, and homes. I think the best way to address this is really through education, because education holds no status quo. And every Filipino child has the right to an education, but not just any education, but quality education. Because I believe if the government can provide this to every Filipino child, then we can not only elevate their quality of life, but we can empower them as well.
Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Makati. Great job, ladies. And just when you thought the competition is over, we are not done yet, because we will have the final question and answer for our final five. For this round, they will answer only one question. The other four delegates will wear noise-canceling headphones. Again, you have 30 seconds to answer. After 30 seconds, you will hear this sound. Here we go. Gentlemen, headphones on. We start off with Baguio. How are you feeling, Baguio?
I'm feeling grateful right now to be in line with the top five. Thank you so much for your support.
Your question is, recently, the Department of Tourism has adopted a new branding campaign. We give the world our best. For you, what is the best that we could offer to the rest of the world? Why do you consider it so?
Having to struggle at a very early age, I had uncertainties, but I received kindness a lot of times. So now, aside from it's free, I give kindness to everyone, because this kindness can go a long way, can motivate someone, or can give radiance to their days. Because this kindness also made me transform myself from a woman who had nothing to a lady that has the universe in her doorstep. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Baguio. Please step forward. Pampanga. Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Recently, the Department of Tourism has adopted a new branding campaign. We give the world our best. For you, what is the best that we could offer to the rest of the world? Why do you consider it so?
I come here not just sharing my story, but the multitude of stories that we have yet to hear, especially for those who are struggling in mental health. I believe the best that we could do and we could share is to remember and to remind everyone of the humanity in us, the empathy that have been inside of us all along, and to unlock it so that we could provide more humanity in humanity. The best way to share that is to allow people safe spaces for mental health so we could further this advocacy and more. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Pampanga. Of course, we have Ms. Bohol. Ms. Bohol, you have plenty of fans. Do you want to greet them?
Maadyong gabi!
Your question is, recently, the Department of Tourism has adopted a new branding campaign. We give the world our best. For you, what is the best that we could offer to the rest of the world? Why do you consider it so?
The best that we offer to the world is the Filipino warmth. It is something that we feel in other countries when we see other Filipino communities, but it's something we feel even more evidently here in the Philippines. And with this slogan at heart, with this value within us, we'll be able to bring so many people together to make a meaningful change out there and show them the best the Philippines has to offer.
Thank you, Ms. Cabal. Please step forward, Ms. Zambales. Are you ready, Ms. Zambales?
Yes, I am.
Your question is, recently, the Department of Tourism has adopted a new branding campaign. We give the world our best. For you, what is the best that we could offer to the rest of the world? Why do you consider it so?
The best that we can give to this world is to be of good cause, to find our purpose, to wake up every single day, be grateful that you still have the chance to live and to see the beauty of life, to find your purpose and make something out of it, to create a great change for the people around you, yourself, your family, and your community. And I hope we strive for betterment and development of each and every individual.
Thank you, Ms. Zambales. And last but not the least, please step forward, Ms. Makati. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling grateful to be standing here in front of all of you once again. Thank you so much.
Your question is, recently, the Department of Tourism has adopted a new branding campaign. We give the world our best. For you, what is the best that we could offer to the rest of the world? Why do you consider it so?
The Philippines is home to very beautiful natural resources, from the beaches to mountains, but I firmly believe that the best natural resource that the Philippines has is us Filipinos. We are the true heart and soul of the Philippines, with the way we are hospitable, with the warm smiles, and we are the reason why the world keeps coming back for more. No matter where the universe takes me, I will always be proud to call the Philippines my home, and no matter what happens, I will always be proud to call myself Pinoy. Thank you.
Thank you, Makati. Ladies and gentlemen, our top five. Mo Arena, these delegates deserve a big hand. Once again, this year's final five.
Baguio. Baguio. Our final five. Baguio. We'll be right back. Zambales. Universe Philippines 2023. You can still vote for your favorite delegate to win the crown in the Miss Universe Philippines app. This is your last chance. Vote now. Find out who will be the new Miss Universe Philippines when we return.
And we're back at the coronation of Miss Universe Philippines 2023. And we're moments away from finding out who will be our next queen.
But before that, let's all bow down to our reigning queen who has made her year purposeful and remarkable. It's time for you to take your final walk, Miss Universe Philippines 2022, Celeste Cortez.
That have made my journey memorable. This meaning of success is not the fifth crown, but that I have truly made a positive and progressive change in so many people's lives. I would like to take these final moments to recall this time last year. As I spoke my heart out to the world, I had yearned to stop time for a day to see my family after a very long time. And when I did, I held my mom the tightest and my wish was granted. Words are indeed powerful, and the universe always had its way to reach out to us because it knows what you truly carry in your heart. If I could also extend my learning to the queens here today, to be lost in the memories of the past or to be caught up overthinking about the future is being absent of the only thing really existing, which is right now. Dahil ang tanging tuntuning sa buhay na hindi magbabago ay ang pagbabago. Don't fear it, ride with it, embrace it. Here I stand now before all of you, transformed and empowered. I make this final vow that I remain in pursuit of leadership and will continue to lead my followers by example. At Sacapalit, huwag ninyong bibitawing ang inyong katotohanan at halaga. Lastly, thank you to the MUPH organization. Thank you to the camp and my mamas for leading me towards this beautiful journey. Thank you to my dear team. You believed in me and stayed by my side no matter what. You are my rock and my safe place. Thank you to my family and friends and to my fans for being so loving and for uplifting me every single day. To my father, grazie per amarmi e proteggermi ovunque vada. Ti amo. Love, Celeste Rabimbi Cortesi, your Miss Universe Philippines 2022.
Ladies and gentlemen, our Miss Universe Philippines 2022, Celeste Cortesi.
Ladies, after months of dedicating yourselves to various activities, trainings, and the causes of the Miss Universe Philippines organization, and after giving your all for this competition, we have finally reached the final point.
That's right, Zosie. The good news is, the results are now in. Tabulated and verified by our official accounting firm, SGV & Company, represented by Mr. Alan Ocho, may the phenomenal and transformational woman win. Here we go.
Our Miss Universe Philippines 2023 second runner-up is Pampanga Angelique Manto.
Miss Universe Philippines 2023, first runner-up is Zambales Christine Opiaza.
To our three remaining ladies, please take center stage.
Three ladies remain, and only one of you will be crowned Miss Universe Philippines 2023.
The new Miss Universe Philippines will be crowned with the La Mer and Majesty crown from Jewel Mer, adorned in golden South Sea pearls, evoking the glory of a national treasure.
Ladies, the moment of truth, the name we will announce is our new Miss Universe Philippines. And the two other ladies will be crowned in a separate ceremony after this event.
Miss Universe Universe Philippines 2023 is...
Miss Universe Philippines 2023 is...
Makati!
Michelle Marquez G!
Congratulations, Michelle! Our new Miss Universe Philippines 2023.
Please take your first walk as Miss Universe Philippines 2023.
This is CN Lim.
And I am Tim Yap. Congratulations to the new and the women, for the men and women behind Miss Universe Philippines organization.
Thank you for joining us tonight and hanging out with us at the Smiley Apparel Lounge. This has been Maureen Montang.
Thank you so much, Philippines, for the very warm welcome. I will be back for sure. And thank you for the love. I am Azozi Tunzi.
And this has been Alden Richards. Thank you for joining us in this year's Miss Universe Philippines, the coronation. Have a good night, everyone. God bless you.
Thank you, everyone.